The HMMWV Humvee is a United States armored vehicle in service since 1985. It is primarily used for infantry transport and light combat. Here is the model Meg Bloks is used to capture its aesthetic. Let's get right into it.
This front piece is all one big piece that comes right off. You can put it back on, no problem. Falls off fairly easily, but that's not too much of a complaint. Moving around to the hood here, it's got two high-tension elastic wires here and here. Those were a real pain to get on, but once you do have them on, they look really nice on the Humvee itself. Hood, nice and smooth, some bumpy parts here to give it a more rugged military look. When you pop the hood open, you can see the V8 engine right here. Witness that. Put that up right there, and that'll keep the hood open if you want to have any of your guys look like they're repairing it or checking it out. Now, like with previous sets, including the BTR, the rear view mirrors are tinted. Maybe not so much tinted as they just have some silver paint, but it does look nicer than just a flat color, and it really adds to the immersion of the set. The tires, of course, are made of rubber. They look very nice in and of themselves, but it's nothing new. We've got all these before. Let's take it to the side of the set. These doors are a big step up from the previous Humvee that we got. The previous one I actually will show at the end of the video so you can know what I'm talking about in the comparison, but I'd actually like to say that this whole model is actually a major improvement and step forward from it. The doors are built off of these custom pieces right here with windows, as well as some other smaller pieces to once again give it a more rugged military look. All of them open all the way like this and close up just like that. Right here, we have one of the newer large backpack pieces. You can put items on the either side or any of the pegs there, but I wouldn't recommend it. Makes it look like they stick out too far and just doesn't look right. Let's flip this thing around to the other side. Now, this shovel here that you see in the back does not actually come in the set. I added this because they had an extra shovel piece, as well as an extra one of these clip-on pieces, and they just had a free hole space there, so I peg that in and, you know, it looks nice, but your final set will not have that. It'll look like that, but that's boring and plain. Let's put that back on. Perfect. Let's move to the top of the set here. Now we have the big gun. This is an M220 TOW missile launcher. While I would have preferred a 50 caliber machine gun like on the previous Humvee set, this one is a nice build in and of itself, and it looks really good. And yeah, there's not much else to say about it. There is a missile inside of it that I can pull out to show you. Oh my god, that was a pain in the ass to get out, but there you go. Same missile we've seen before in the M2 Bradley set, and I can't show it all here because my fingers will get in the way and it'll just be out of focus. Perfect. There you go. Look at that missile. Nothing too special, but that goes right back in here. And you can see the warhead sticking out the front right there. The TOW missile launcher itself tilts up and down and will turn around 360 degrees, provided you don't get the little handle there for your infantry guy to hold stuck in the circular top compartment of the hump. Anyway, moving around to the back here. Here we have kind of a cargo hold, I suppose you could call it. A net piece held down by two pegs, has two sandbags inside of it. Do the job nicely of looking at, you know, various cargo sacks, and you can't really complain. Mega Bloks worked with what they had, and what they got was a pretty good result. Also on the back here, you will see four jerry cans, 1, 2, 3, and 4. There's also a license plate here, which reads MAO7466. Maybe it's a reference to something, maybe it's just random letters and numbers, I don't know. Let's move on to the trunk now. The trunk opens up in actually a pretty cool way. First off, you can flip these jerry cans down. Next, you can pull the whole hood up and you'll reveal the care package inside, as well as places to put your troops there and there. Also, you can pull the care package out. See, it comes with a spare missile for the M220 TOW launcher on the roof. Having a quick look at the contents of the care package, it's nothing we haven't seen before. We've got a canteen, walkie-talkie, spare magazine for one of your infantry's guns, a set of binoculars, flashlight, and of course, the missile. That of course can't fit in the care package, but you can throw it in the extra space you have in the trunk, or put it inside the main compartment of the Humvee. Speaking of the interior compartment of the Humvee, let's take the roof section off here and have a look inside. All right, so what we got here is a pretty simple layout. Four seats, driver, three passengers, steering wheel up there. I'm gonna zoom the camera way in as close as I can so you can see there's not too much detail underneath the driver's seat, no gas or brake, but it does have a gear shift as well as some screens here, I suppose for dials and I guess it's a radio. Probably some military stuff that I don't even want to pretend to understand. Nice textured piece there that's not a sticker or just a drawing on one of the pieces. That's an actual carving into the piece and it looks pretty cool. Turn it around and you can see that there's a compartment to store items in there. You can store items such as the stuff you saw in the care package, like this little canteen. Look at that, looks beautiful. Right here is a seat where you can have your guy not so much sit, but stand to operate the tow missile launcher and stand out of the hole there. But at the end of the review, I'll show you what it looks like with all the guys in their seats. As for the seats themselves, they just have pegs and that fell off. This is a problem though. This part falls off on the set a lot and it's hard to get back on. I would recommend using some plastic bonding glue to make it stick. You can see how much trouble I'm having already. And there you go. Now, before we move on to the guys, there is one last thing I want to show you. Check this out. Mega Bloks is great at doing this, putting in little details that really sell their set. I'm going to pull this all the way out so you can see what I mean, but they actually put the drive motors and gears underneath the set to give it a really, really authentic look. I don't think they've ever done this before, and I really appreciate that extra level of detail. With the Humvee out of the way, let's get into the three figures that are included with this set. The first figure we're going to take a look at is the one in the middle. This one resembles more of a special forces operator, what with a boonie hat and sunglasses. Mega Bloks have also painted a little bit of hair on the back of his head, just for an extra level of detail. His chest piece is not the full-size ballistic vest, but it's just the plain straps with a pouch right there. You can also see he comes with the pockets and collar on his main chest piece. His weapon that he comes with is a personal favorite of mine, the Vector K10 submachine gun, here included with the grip and red dot sight as per usual Mega Bloks sets. The only thing I am a little upset with is that he doesn't come with any leg accessories. Not too big a deal, definitely not a deal breaker, great figure in general. The next figure we're going to take a look at here is more resembling of a proper soldier. Here, this one comes with a full-sized combat vest, with a grenade, flashbang, or whatever you want that to be on his chest. A helmet, colored nicely, with some face exposed right there, and tinted goggles. Again, no leg pieces, but that's not too big of a problem. But look at this. I told you about this earlier, and I really want to show this off. This is a brand new weapon Mega Bloks has done, I believe for the first time. It's an MTAR 21 carbine or assault rifle. It doesn't come with any optic though, which does make it look a little bit weird, but I'll show you what it does look like with an optic soon enough. The magazine here is brand new actually, rather than the more curved traditional magazines you've seen with previous Mega Bloks sets. This one is a little more straight and slightly more detailed to look like a more modern 21st century magazine. Of course it goes in the back since the MTAR is a bullpup styled weapon, and the grip it comes with is the same grip that's included with all Vector K10 submachine guns. Same thing with the middle, that's a Vector middle, but it's a brand new backstock and front end specifically for this weapon. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a silver red dot sight to put on the MTAR, but you can see even with a green one, the whole aesthetic of the weapon improves very nicely, and it does look like a proper modern military assault rifle. With the two previous minifigures out of the way, let's get on to my favorite one in the set. Already you can see he's more heavily armored than most of the figures we've gotten before. That's due in part because he comes with a Juggernaut midsection that we got with the original Juggernaut standalone set, two pouches on the back, and two grenades, flashbangs on the chest. He comes with colored boots and a claymore attached to his waist strap right there. His helmet is a brand new design. It looks very authentic to the helmets that you see modern US infantrymen use, as well as a wrap around his lower face section. You can see his eyes, and unfortunately they do fall victim to the Mega Bloks dotted eyes effect where they look cold and dead. The weapon he comes with is the RPK light machine gun. Here it comes with a strap, something that Mega Bloks been putting in a lot of their recent sets by just attaching a rubber band around the barrel and buttstock. If you've been collecting these sets recently, you've probably seen this thing before. It comes with a drum magazine, bipod, large AK style forend with a an M4 style backstock. Everything else about him though just screams heavy gunner. This guy looks like a real tank. I mean, like I said, new personal favorite minifigure. I did want to show you guys the set with all the figures inside, so here you go. At the top here, I've got the heavy gunner juggernaut type firing the tow missile launcher. Moving the roof, you can first see the soldier in the back with his weapon, ready to get out the door, ready for combat. And we can see I have the special forces operator driving the Humvee and operating the stick shift right there. There is one more addition I think you guys might find interesting. Let me cut to it right now.
That's what this thing was missing, a 50 caliber machine gun. Now, I always thought the M220 tow launcher looked like too heavy a weapon for too small a vehicle. The 50 cal, on the other hand, perfectly complements the style of this Humvee and makes it look more like a modern, contemporary Humvee.
Moving into a wide shot here, you can see the distinct similarities between the original 2013 model Humvee and the new 2016 model Humvee, especially once you put the 50 cal on top of this one. Now, when I first saw this Humvee, I thought it was the coolest thing ever, but after seeing it next to the 2016 model, I gotta say, this one blows this one right out of the water. This one, like I showed you before, fully constructed back section, but this one is oddly missing that. It also has weird square windows and mesh or netting. I don't even know what that is for doors. Whereas this one has fully armored, all decal, looks really nice kind of doors. Anyway, that about wraps up the review of the set. Let's finish this thing up. This has been the Armored Vehicle Charge Review. If you like the video, please like the video. It shows your support. If you want to see more videos like this video, please hit that subscribe button. I always like to see more people come onto the channel. If you have any comments, questions, anything you want to tell me, leave it down in the comments section below. Stay tuned for my next review, where we'll be going back in time to 1968 and taking a cruise down the Mekong River in Vietnam. Thank you all for watching. This is Sweet Lead Roll, rolling out. Have a good one.